I'm so fucking sick and tired of the Photoshop. Show me something natural like Afro with your bra.
If you wanna be my baby, no, I'm gonna drive you mad. Probably gonna call me crazy. I'm the best you ever had, yeah. I can turn you on, on, on. Why your clothes still on?
Sometimes people get confused when they see a makeup video and are faced with texture. Many people grew up learning the art of makeup through the guise of YouTube. Many grew up unaware of camera filters, the intricacies of photo retouching, how makeup actually looks in real life. Beauty gurus lied to you. They sold you foundations while donning a blurring filter without showing you the way it truly looked. They told you that makeup was undetectable. They told you that it looked like an airbrush while airbrushing their skin in post-production. So let me let you in on a secret. Makeup will always look like makeup, not skin. By its nature, it sits on the skin, and being human, texture is normal. Humans of all sorts have pores and lines, little bumps. Your skin carries the memory of where it's been, and makeup can't hide that. It's not cakey, you're just seeing texture.
Absolutely. So this is me. I'm in my car right now. I'm outside. I think outside is natural lighting, but here's, you know, my skin with no beauty filters on. Yeah. I hope this helps. I get the whole, like, skin doesn't really look like that, but I feel weird participating in this because I don't have textured skin, so my makeup actually looks like what I show it. I don't know.
Foundation powder mix.
This trend has been going around TikTok for months, so I had to try it out, and it made my skin look disgusting. It did me dirty. My skin don't typically look like this. Sometimes I wonder if y'all just hype shit up for the views.
How foundation really blends on my textured skin.
I hate to say it, but my makeup doesn't look like this. It's all lighting.
Yes, this is so important to show what real makeup looks like. Right now, I have three lights in front of me. One here, and one here. And of course, my makeup's gonna look flawless because all the shadows and textures being taken away. But it's so important because sometimes we think, like, why does our makeup look different than others? Because we're seeing ourselves in person versus seeing all these false versions of people on social media. So let me show you what my makeup really looks like. I also did the foundation challenge today where I used tons of makeup. You can check that TikTok out. But this is how it really looks in person. You can see there's cracking, there's texture. You can see like some scars underneath if I go really close. And then this is with those lights off. You can see everyone has flaws and bumps and texture. It's normal. No one looks airbrushed 24/7. That is a false reality. And here's different lighting. You can see regular skin, regular texture. Please do not believe what you see online because it's not real. I think sometimes people get confused when they see a makeup video and are faced with texture. Many people grew up learning the art of makeup through the guise of YouTube. Many grew up unaware of camera filters, the intricacies of photo retouching, how makeup actually looks in real life. Beauty gurus lied to you. They sold you foundations while donning a blurring filter without showing you the way it truly looked. They told you that makeup was undetectable. They told you that it looked like an airbrush while airbrushing their skin in post-production. So let me let you in on a secret. Makeup will always look like makeup, not skin. By its nature, it sits on the skin, and being human, texture is normal. Humans of all sorts have pores and lines, little bumps.
Your skin carries the memory of where it's been, and makeup can't hide that. It's not cakey, you're just seeing texture.
With a ring light. Bathroom lighting. In front of a window. Outside lighting. Makeup looks different with different lighting.
I think sometimes people get confused when they see a makeup video and are faced with texture. Many people grew up learning the art of makeup through the guise of YouTube. Many grew up unaware of camera filters, the intricacies of photo retouching, how makeup actually looks in real life. Beauty gurus lied to you. They sold you foundations while donning a blurring filter without showing you the way it truly looked. They told you that makeup was undetectable. They told you that it looked like an airbrush while airbrushing their skin in post-production. So let me let you in on a secret. Makeup will always look like makeup, not skin. By its nature, it sits on the skin, and being human, texture is normal. Humans of all sorts have pores and lines, little bumps. Your skin carries the memory of where it's been, and makeup can't hide that. It's not cakey, you're just seeing texture.